So I go on to YouTube and see this. Three words. What the? Watching this trailer totally blew my mind. The whole map is covered by the iconic orange track from Hot Wheels, and I've noticed that the cars are able to go upside down, so the physics will feel different compared to normal. And did you catch that? The smoke comes off the tires and the flames stay on as both cars go down. Does this mean nitrous is added to the game? It looks like they've added some new cars to the game too. Like the Pagani Zundera, the Zenvo ST1, the Jeep Trailcat, the Arctic Trucks Hilux and many Hot Wheels cars such as the Bone Shaker. On the website I'm reading from, which I'll link in the description, it says check out the new stunt swap feature to modify stunt track sections and dare your friends to try them. So this is basically telling us that we could create our very own tracks. How awesome is that? We could create a massive oval, have a crossroad or even recreate tracks like the Nürburgring, even though that probably isn't possible. This is also very good for drifters in Horizon 3, as they could create a track with a lot of hairpins, like the Transfigurizon Highway. I've gone over everything I'm looking forward to, now here are the things which I dislike. When they were making Gymkhana 9, they said,
"We're trying to create something which is over the top and unrealistic and could never happen."
I understand this part, telling us that he wanted to keep everything arcadey, which is why they've added jumps and loops in the tracks. But why can't we engine swap any engine into any car? Just imagine having an Isetta or a Reliant Supervan with an Aventador V12. I'd have crazy amounts of fun. Just before this video ends, I'd like to remind everyone that the expansion pack comes out on May the 9th and the price will be $20, which is around £16. Until next time.